Welcome to this shed floor framing video. Here you will learn about the steps to framing a shed floor. This video shows you the necessary steps for shed floor framing, from laying out the rim joists to squaring the joist system. The first step to building the shed floor is to install layout marks on the rim joist boards. Prepare the boards for the layout marks by cutting the rim joist boards to the length shown on the plans and then standing the two rim joist boards on edge next to each other. Make sure that the crown edge is on the top sides and that the ends of the boards are flush with each other. Now you are ready to mark the layout marks on the two boards. We will be marking the floor joist locations at 16 inches on center. Hook your tape measure on the ends of the two boards, pull the tape measure down, and put a mark at 16 3/4 inches. Then put an X on the side of the mark closest to the tape measure hook end to help you remember what side of the mark the floor joist will go on. Continue making marks every 16 3/4 inches along the edges of the boards. The reason you go 3/4 inch past is because the floor joist boards that you will be installing on the marks are 1.5 inches wide. If the center of the board is to be at 16 inches on center, then the edge will need to be 3/4 inch past the 16-inch point. It is easier to line up the edge of the board with the mark than it is to line up the center of the board. Thus, the marks are at 16 3/4, 32 3/4, 48 3/4, and so on. Once all the layout marks are made, you will transfer the marks to the other board and make a line across both boards using a speed square. Make sure that both boards have an X to show the side of the mark that the joist will go on. The second step in building the shed floor joist system is to set the rim joists and floor joists on the foundation rails. Start by separating the rim joists and set them on the foundation rails. Make sure that the rim joist layout marks are still facing up and that the layout marks start on the same end of the shed. Crown each of the floor joists and then set them down on the foundation rails and align them with the layout marks you made earlier on the rim joists. The third step is to nail the rim boards to each of the floor joists. For 2x6 and 2x8 floor joists, you will use 3 nails at each connection. Make sure that each floor joist end is aligned with its respective layout mark before nailing. The fourth step is to attach the rim boards to the foundation rails. Line the rim board outer edges up with the outer edges of the foundation rails, and then nail the rim boards to the rails by toenailing at 16 inches on center. It is also recommended to use an angled framing connector every 3 to 4 feet to strengthen the connection of the floor joist system to the foundation rails. The fifth and final step is to make sure the floor framing is square so you can attach the floor sheeting. This is done by measuring diagonally from corner to corner. Your goal is to get both of the diagonal measurements to be the same length. Measure the two diagonals and then move one of the rim joist boards and the floor joists attached to it parallel to the other side until the two diagonal measurements are the same. This is a quick view of the diagonals on an 8x10 shed that has been squared. Continue learning about shed building by clicking on one of these videos. Thanks for watching.